page 144 in the English.
Не бас, че это не. Говорит, не ба, та таба джубе нам гиря, хитян ла паба ла низ, тюнги ngô ла читар чава, тюнзам ла читар чава чуюс, та тюнги ngô ла сиду, ngô ла чорнгой чусум, тамбу чува низ, Yamne kundu lam malhabela tuwa doji chanla suwa dip stati di godi tenang lamri godi li yarba tena ma dui shari sun dip re di yarba odi di chowa di Yamne kundu lam malhabela Yamne kundu lam malhabela Jamne dag, Jamne gundu betani, Lama label has, the Lama label, the Lama than label has, no year met dog weary, that he nag loot and derba. Just a Lama than label, no year met dog weary, but he Lama label, two or two channels, so at him, the Lama. Label ha tuwa toji chanla tal na tuwa toji jati lama yimba label ha yungu yimba tuwa toji chanla suwan dip stati suwan dip tiche.
So here for determining the nature of the path to liberation, there are two parts here. First is about how to conduct the session, and then the second one is what to do in the break between sessions. So for that first one, you have the preparations, then the actual session, and then you have the conclusion of the session. And for that first one, the preliminaries or the preparation for the actual session, it's like it says on page 145 for those who have the book. It says, "I pray to you, unity of the objects of refuge, my Guru Supreme, Deity Shakyamuni, Vajradhara." So this is like in the other meditations, you make the request. You make a request to the guru who's seen as inseparable from one special deity, or it says supreme deity here, Habila, who's also inseparable from Shakyamuni and Shakyamuni Buddha and Vajradhara. So the request is made in this way because of the connection with the Vajrayana practice. So because of the connection with the Vajrayana practice, then you have the request to the guru inseparable from Vajradhara, Shakyamuni, and the special deity.
Karasure, Lamri Jubatila Tiari Karasure, Lamri Tila Karasure, Ani Karasure, Jubatila Lamri Jubatila Sumyavata Karasa Kadam. Kantam shungawa siya chiche. Kantam mengaba siya chiche. Kantam lamrimbas siya sumiyarba. Jinte ta lamri, andu lamri kyebati kantam shungawa nashinri. Shungu chula sopati niti chani siya yarba lamri kyebati. Tene ani kadam lamrim ba se ati tile tu ba ta lamri tus kadam lamrim ba se tu pena sishu ma se ati ari lamri sishu ma se ati kiawa nga ma nga ba gantse ba tin do kyang ba re tene kadam me nga be se ati lamri tanda Telam de Gatam Mengabit de Gatam Mengamba in security Mengamba said de Nathan de Shavitil Lambritilla Gatam Mengamba said de Lambrit Yamsun into Nathan training Yamsulin Yetilla Gatam Mengaba to Duchen Telegatam Mengaba said Jason Tandetti Lambrit. Telam ti ni ngatin dewari gone ma ngatin dewari ande deje deje re 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 la tu tin pe jan ta tin de yerwa o ti jesa ti ngatin dewari jesa ti kada me nga be ki ba yin si gere kada me nga be ki ba kada me nga ba ti Alam di cungu di kata mengabe luks sumare.
Now, there are three stages of the path or Lamrim lineages. We have one which is referred to as the Kadampa text followers. Follower system. So the system of the Kadampas who rely on the text or follow the text, that's what it's called. So this would be involve the more extensive stages of path expositions. And then you have the system of the Kadam stage of the path practitioners. So that's a slightly more abbreviated or concise presentation of the stage of the path they have. There would be an example of that would be like the what we call Lam Sishuma. So that's like the essence of refined gold, I think is usually translated as, or just simply pure gold. The Lamrim text, which is called Pure Gold, that was actually composed by the great fifth Dalai Lama, and that's only sutra. So that's all presented in the sutra terms. It's only a sutra practice. Then you have the third tradition, which is called the Kadam quintessential instructions tradition. So that's the Lamrim Mengakpa. So that would refer that, that an example of that would be this text, the Delam, or the easy path, as it's been translated for this book, the path to bliss, Delam. So this is one which is connected with, or is sort of like mixed with the Vajrayana practice. So so that's what we're looking at here. That's what we have here. The easy path, Lamrim, is one which involves is mixed with the Vajrayana practice. And so right from the beginning with each meditation, you have this practice of imagining that you're purifying with descending nectar. So you receive nectar from the merit field objects, which purify you. So this is all sort of that's part of the Delam, or the easy path Lamrim practice, because of the connection with the Vajrayana.
That is that in a Sundip Dienche Narshin said the Sundip Sheva inches that. Narhi said that Bon Sunsan, that teacher. That in a dene Dada Massimje Tamje Qua Jene Uring La Shoot Travis Dunge Nazoba Yonkova di Taba Denig Logene, Lamlava Sumla, Suishindo, Malabe Lambertus, Tandapato, Coagene, Dunge, any sugar trouble, Yuringbu, Dunge Nazobachi, Tian Dungen Chingi, but Dunge Nazobachi, Yonati, Yonkoya, the carriage ever, carry Lambato, carriage Lambato. Karilendo spatache chevina ne tabatungi go lob kene lamela bo sumda chuishin do malo ba teletene ni kwa yurin do kene tungen na to ba nyonku ba te teletu shas ada ti dubes dada masim jetinyo.
What it mentions in the text is that the request at first is just like before, which I've already taught, and then, like it says in the translation here, this is how you would think: all mother sentient beings and I have been born in samsara and have endured a host of intense sufferings over a long time. This is due to not learning properly the path of the three higher trainings after developing a desire for liberation. So what this is saying is that up until now, oneself and all the mother sentient beings have been experiencing terrible suffering in psychic existence, all kinds of suffering, so many different kinds of suffering. And if we investigate the reason for that, we discover that it's all of that happened due to the fact that we didn't generate the wish, the desire to achieve liberation, and then having generated that wish, that determination, then learned about and practiced the three higher trainings. That's why that's been happening.
Dine dada si tu susurva masimje se de simje tamje rang ma jingyu chatare ma jingyu shi Machiwe negosu katimpatu mebe kyangbat shatarvach re machiwe negosu. Oti insa, ti insa ni taata maasimje thamje se, semje thamje ta maasiyati rangi machi nyuyimba. Machiwe negosu ti insa, tse mebe kyangba insa, ani taata maasimje thamje se ati tiri. Taata se to susu che. Masimje tamje sidu, rali shimbe simje tamje rangi ma chingu, dia ma le mambu chingu, ma chibe negusa dinse mebe kyambati, shada dinsa, the masimje tamje sidu.
And so it says here, all mother sentient beings and I, that's talking about ourself, and then when it says all mother sentient beings, that's talking about all other sentient beings beside oneself, and this is referring to the fact that phrase refers to the fact that all of those all of the sentient beings, all other sentient beings have been one's mother. There's not one of them that hasn't been one's mother, and when they were our mother, their kindness to us was immeasurable. They took care of us with so much kindness. So they were all our mother. There's not one that wasn't. And not only that, but many times, each of them has been our mother many times, and each time has been immeasurably kind to us.
Tadine dada masim jitam jesir kuwar gene yurindu ta kuwar gene sedu Chidang kwa se di kwa se di nyene pungpo la kwa su nye yare. Yang kwa se di ngunzu jiteng ki kam di di kwe ne se gare. Kwa se nye di nyene pungpo shi la sha. Kwa se di kwa nye di rang rab di che. Kora genes, kors, korosiati, Korsia tita lenji ma imba ya shi ya ti ya tile ne ya lenyu ju ya tile ke yen tu se korsia tite ba ta chi da ko ase ti ne len pung bi che de ne shi ne ya ne len pung bu shin da ji je wa chi ma nya mi li ke ne mi ne len pung bi le ni kor je te ju re Then Adila Kwasje Mundu Kwa Kwa Junior de Caras, Lady Nimuni, but the Kwa Kwa Junior de Kwa Kwa Nye de Ranje Korsa de Lenin Pumbushila Korje de Gere Lenin Pumbutilan Sonata to Nijan Jerva Lenin Pumbuchina Pumbutilan Chinja to any. Kulatene tungi kyanja mampu chungu yarwa. Wadi insata kwa seyate lenyu chupungu chilaje. Tela kore tenye di kansa susu che. Kwa se, kwa pote se. Kore junye di ledi nye mungi di che. Rangke yamare. Ledi nye mungi. Ani susu yapu che kya dene ya. Letting you move on the cool, let Sashina any ambachili gigger of a course, Lenny Junk. Corjunity, letting you moon it. What is a duck? Qua said it.
Remission is in Java said it, a Kiwalam but in Chipper.
Ah,
Ningsam Java.
Kiwalam Java seer.
Kiwalam but
Jolim but it. Kiwalam but this in the year, Kiwalam but it. Ani kualisha, ni zaman jawa, jawa lembut, pungbusi jarwar ba. Lengi tu orang susu, tungen tu pungbusi le jarwar cahdi le tak kuasa kira. Tadi penam raji rarab cije, di thapa cige cije, thapa cige kawal cingbai na, rati rang kuah kuni cije rang se cije. Tapati lenini putiche. Tala tapati radi kawajil tabrava. The go kawajil koji de juri, tapati machepato. Ne korje de yerva. Ditch nashijene lenini ungi ne tabala jingbe chati. Kuasi shigir. Jesanta. Jinya titine manju rati ba rat thapage kawajile tamsuna rati ngaranzu che thapadile ngini che tamse tinya ni phungbu che che ni tambe chadile ta khoase gare ta dile ko thapad ma che padu ko te khoje te ju Kawajil kore kepje te kirwa wati usre chiri.
Now, when it says here, so all mother sentient beings and I have been born in samsara. So, have been born in samsara. Samsara, according to certain teachings, according to certain teachers, the samsara refers to the appropriated aggregates, as they're often called, nyelingipumbo, or the grasping aggregates, another way of putting it. So what this means is, so the world where we live in is referred to as the samsara, as a place. So a samsaric place is the samsaric place, or the place where the samsara takes place. The one who is circling, so samsara mean, we call it in English cyclic existence, so it has the idea of circling, right? So the one who's circling is oneself, and we circle. What that means is we're born and then we die, and this doesn't just happen once. Again, we are born, again, we die, and we're born again. So it's like a circle in that sense. And so when we talk about the cyclic existence, or samsara cyclic existence, that refers to the grasping or appropriated aggregates. And it can be when you've been born as a human being, then you die, maybe you're going to be born in the hell realm, so then you would take the aggregates of a human being. If you're going to be born as a hell being, then after that life, you know, so you die as a human being, then you're born, you have the aggregates of a hell being. If you're born as an animal, then you have the aggregates of an animal, and so on. So that's fine. That's quite a reasonable way to describe the process, and in terms of cyclic existence being the aggregates, the appropriated aggregates. Otherwise, in general, the samsara cyclic existence is described as taking birth under the control of karma and klesha, or the actions and the destructive thoughts and emotions. So taking birth, connecting with the aggregates under the the appropriated aggregates under the control of the karma and the destructive thoughts and emotions. Under the control of them means they are what make us take birth and go to these different sets of aggregates, because we don't actually have the choice. If we had if it was up to us, then we would go on to something nice. But in fact, because we, you know, if we've created the karma to go on to something bad, then that's what's going to happen because of our karma and our destructive thoughts and emotions. We don't just pick and choose, you know, where we're going to be born. And so again, then the one who is circling is oneself. So it's the person who's circling where the appropriated aggregates which are taken under the control of the destructive thoughts and emotions, and then so long as we're stuck in that process, then we have to experience immeasurable suffering. So we can understand this in terms of the analogy of an animal that's been tied to a stake. So the rope that ties the creature to the stake would be equivalent to karma and the destructive thoughts and emotions. And so the stake would be like that piece of wood. The stake would be like the appropriated aggregates, samsara, in other words, and one would. Oneself would be like the creature that's tied to that stake, who has no choice but to just go around the stake until that rope has been broken through. So it'd be like that. Nos.
Tadene, a yulin la shu tagi, tungena to, nyoa di. That harpa to niglo makibe ongte is ta. That harpa to niglo. That harpa seat tangi quatidva, quatili tarpa seat. Tarpa seat, jitan tarpa tub seat, jama quale tarpe chachi jitu jujerva tarpa seat. Tarpa seat tangi tarsat garbele tores quale taru. That harpa to niglo. dat kua kua na nebe nega su dunge yuring la shu taba ani dunge na so bachi ngong ku chi ti samnu ta yin du ta dile than du lo chi ge ger ba ge gu ge re ta kua ta ku a wati chi se tarba tu ni gi lo se tarba se ti kale thar gure re se na kua le tan chi kua chi she bin ba kua le thar gu gure se che tarba tu ni gi lo ma ki ba ti ong gi lo ma ki ni la ba sum la ma ma le be ong gi len sha se se re ba ta tarba tu ni gi lo se ti tarba se ti kua le tarba che that tarba tu ni lo che su ne ta ni ka re su kwa de tarba tu ni lo chi ke ne ta kwa le tarwe tap de ta chu chu de ba ani chu de ya ji ting gi ya ba kwa le tan de lo ta kwa le tan de lo ke ba le ka re su ne yu rin bu ru kwa ne su ne ne ju ani dung ne di shu ta bu dia ani dungen na zo ba chi shu da bu chi ma yin ba dungen na ba na zo chi dung ju di ge dung e chi jin du dung e ge sin ye ba dung e du sin ye ba dung e sum se ya te ya ke ga na chi dung e se ta ti dung e na zo ba chi ngung ju di xie su na chen su na ane da dung e di le me du be lo ki ge ba tatile tandugu lochi gi kwadile odi ji jesa tandugu lochi ne tine tandugu lochi suna tata tabdil garuchu gure sene ta lam la ba sum se atli loku tu samit gi gi yare ta tinje lochi ma gi be lemba tu se
And so also in terms of that analogy, what it is that we are in a sense tied to is the aggregates, the appropriated aggregates. And then we can think of some samsara cycle existence as being as meaning to be tied, or in other words, samsara is being tied to those aggregates. So what this is saying is the reason that we've been suffering so much and having to experience such a variety of suffering that goes on for so long is because we didn't generate the mind wishing to achieve liberation. Liberation from what? From cyclic existence. So liberation, tarpa, liberation, or liberation, freedom, means freedom from the aggregates, the appropriated aggregates. And so what we need to understand from this then is that we have been in psychic existence for such a long time, experiencing so much suffering, so many different kinds of suffering, such intense suffering. So if we think about that, then naturally the wish to achieve liberation from it will happen, will arise in us. So liberation from what? From cyclic existence. Having generated that mind wishing to achieve liberation from cyclic existence, then we'll see that the method that we need to practice in order to be free is the three trainings. So generally speaking, the antidote to cyclic existence is practicing Dharma. And so thinking in the way in which we are experiencing, we have been experiencing such horrendous suffering, thinking of the terrible suffering of cyclic existence, the great variety of ways in which one suffers in cyclic existence, thinking about the suffering nature of cyclic existence in terms of the eight sufferings, or in terms of the six types of suffering, the three types of suffering, thinking about that, the wish not to experience that will arise. The mind not wanting to experience that will arise. In other words, the mind wanting to be liberated from it will arise. And then we have to think about how we're going to liberate ourselves from it. And we will see that what it comes down to is practicing the three trainings. And it's because we didn't ever generate that mind wanting to be free, and then based on that, we didn't practice the three higher trainings. That's why we, so far we have been suffering in cyclic existence and haven't been free from it.
Lava dingi lava, lava shirab lava asche, diche sum diris.
And when it talks about the three trainings, the lam lava sum, so the path of the three trainings, then this is the method for achieving liberation. And if we list them one by one, we have the training in morality, the training in concentration, and training in wisdom.
Oh, that ne, lava chudim ki lava se ati karasene chida chudim ki lava dila chudim dila su su tharbe chudim su dag chudim se achi. Dine chanju chanju sembe chudim sanga ki Tombas, Jansim Gitomba, Sanga Gitombas, Soda Gitombas, Sunduga, Tusu, Lava Chudim Gilabinal, Dudukiadis.
In terms of the this, yeah, the training in morality in general, we have the morality of individual liberation, because we have the vows of individual liberation. So having received that, then you have the morality of guarding those vows. And then you also have the bodhisattva vows, or the bodhisattva ordination, as we often refer to it. So you have the bodhisattva morality. Then likewise, there's the tantric or vajrayana morality from having taken the vajrayana ordination or vows. And so those types of morality are all included within the training in morality.
Ah, that is ne. Ngarandu me soju ba pangsu na soju pangu chutim sigiri. Majin ba lemba pangsu na majin lemba pangu chutim sje. Migu chubu chutim sje shituga. Migichubu se migichuti sojuba majimba limba loyim sinim majim mitamba chuba sumche. Ani zu chama tsizu ngage situ ani tila lunga gudun sigare. Tane yiki sum naksim nusim lusim lota siyarba. Oti tila Migichu cigare. Dipon a chutim chuyarba, chutim chuyare. Then it not so jug means silabina, so jupon a chutim laying yare. And in metang bejug means and a metanchu chutim laying yare. Kelensuna. And in not so majimba lingi means, kumakug means, kelinchabina. Majini pambe chutim sigare, chutim siyati. Tatusu laba chutim ki laba tiki karachiki yaresena, ngazugi ani kuwa kichiki le, nane sota ki tombarabu tichena, sota ki tomba tiki, kenyi ki tomba siya cherwa, kenyi ki tomba tiki, ani karasugure lunga le soju pume le yarba soju bele mezamba chu bele majimba lembele зүйма байлэ сиярба а од ле тигети миге өлэри тиге кан миге өлэрба тусу а лунга гле тиге пунгияри чи пун инди чэм не чеса чудим гип а чудим глабаги лунга гле чуди лунга гле тиге пунгияри Tine labatingi jing labatigi lunga gi le tusu gi kunung migiwa nyomu batusu ngungiwa pungiari. Ta shirab gi labala tene nyomu basabin da jeba pungiari. Ta te kuwa giji gi ta kuwa kuwa jungi di le nyingi ba. Kuala kor junge di lenyu nyi. Dina ne di lenyu nyi yisa ne di pungji ki tabdi la. Lenyu nyi bu di pungji ki tabdi la ta laba sumusikar. Di laba churingi laba di ni mikiwe le sujingi le di zu pungji kari. Di ngaranzu ki. Ta laba Tingi tingi laba tingi legi kulung yarwa, le ti saa ya ti nyumumbe ongi saki yarwa, nyumumbe ngungiwa kogi yari, zu. Sabin ti jeba ti paantu ya mari. Da ti sabin ti jeba paayala kari laba shiruki laba tingi, sabin ti jeba pungi yari. Chani, Laba shirabila laba la tene ni kuwa tili thagi yari. Thagi yari. Chene, one laba tengi tingi laba tiki karichigi yari sene kuwa tzawa ti paa matu ne yang. Le ngungu wa tiki, nyamu ngungu wa tiki kagi yari. Sui, rangi jula nyamu ngondi juya ti paa kagi yari. Ngondi ma june paa ya maari. Paa siti ku Kujula kondu mene yang kondu paan kukuya maare. Kondu maibati shindaji jambarabji ngondu kuyundi kondu rabji hiruruba. Jambati kondu ngungiwa paan tukuya re. Ine yang kondu paan tukuya maare. Yang jamba mena kondu diya ngondu kukuruba. Tati zawane mebasu nye di laba shiruku laba kukuya re.
Okay, so to keep going with the training in morality, so for example, if you were to abandon, in other words, make the decision not to kill, not to engage in killing, then you would have the morality of abandoning killing, taking the life of another being. Likewise, if you were to make the decision not to steal, then you'd have the morality of not stealing. So in this way, you have the morality of abandoning the 10 non-virtues. So morality of abandoning each of those. So you have those 10 moralities. So the morality of abandoning the 10 non-virtues. The 10 non-virtues are the 3 of the body, which means killing, stealing, and sexual misconduct. And then you have the 4 of speech, which are lying, divisive speech, harsh speech, and idle gossip. Senseless speech. So those are the 7 of body and speech. Then you have the 3 of the mind, which are covetousness, ill will, and wrong view. So those are the 10 non-virtues. And so we have the morality of abandoning the 10 non-virtues. So when you make the when you sort of take it upon yourself, you make the decision that you're not going to kill, or you're not going to steal, or you're not going to engage in sexual misconduct, then you would have the morality of abandoning killing and so forth. And likewise, you can make the commitment not to engage in impure behavior, and you know, not to have sexual relations at all, which means then you would have that morality. So we have the morality of individual liberation, pratimoksha, associated with the pratimoksha vow or ordination, within which we have the ordination or vows of the upasaka, which is the householder, or what we often call the lay vows. So those are mainly to do with the non-virtues of body and speech. So it would involve abandoning the karma, the non-virtuous karma of killing, stealing, lying, and so forth. So you would abandon those non-virtuous karmas. So that's more or less about the training in morality. So it's mainly with the training in morality. What you do is you're able to abandon the non-virtuous actions of body and speech. So then, with the training in concentration, you're able to stop the manifest, destructive thoughts and emotions which act as the motivation for the kunlong, the motivation for engaging in those seven of body and speech, from becoming manifest. So in other words, normally when we engage in those seven non-virtues of body and speech, then the motivation would be the destructive thoughts and emotions. When they become manifest, they would act as the motivation. So the training and concentration stops those destructive thoughts and emotions from being able to become manifest. And so it's able to stop those, but it's not able to actually abandon them along with their seeds. That's something that you can only do with the training in wisdom. It's the training in wisdom that is able to actually abandon the root of of psychic existence, by abandoning the seeds of the klesha, or the destructive thoughts and emotions. So it's in this way that the three train, with the practice of the three trainings, you're able to abandon psychic existence. First of all, with the training morality, where you abandon the seven non-virtues of body and speech. With the training in concentration, you're able to stop the motivations for those actions from becoming manifest, because you're able to stop the destructive thoughts and emotions from being manifest, but you're not able to abandon the seeds of those destructive thoughts and emotions. It's this training in wisdom that does that. And so it's mainly through the training in wisdom that you finally can achieve a liberation. With concentration, you're able to stop the destructive thoughts and emotions, but you're not able to abandon them from the root by abandoning the seeds. You simply prevent them from becoming manifest. You don't abandon them. Like, for example, in the case of anger, just because there's no anger in your mind, in your continuum, at a particular point, it's not necessarily the case that you've abandoned it. It's not there in your mind at that time, but that doesn't mean to say that you've necessarily abandoned it. So that's what happens with the training in concentration. It stops them from arising in your continuum, in your mind, in your continuum, but it hasn't abandoned them, so they can come back. Like, for example, when we meditate on love, then that prevents anger from arising. But when you stop the meditation on love, then the anger can come back. So it's just like that.
Just love, kama ani kama ngatu chine thune tinga ji la pachi le yung ya re odi di kamdu la chi chi be nega chila chungsu na nyamunga di jyothu marwa di nega su kur kamdu la chi chi tu ne terwa wana jamba la chi chi tu ne be nega su kundu ngundu jyothu miduga ya odi nega su ta lava tingi ting lava chi ya re odi lava tingi ting lava ti tsochiwa ti shine je shine in je je ti wale ya ngaranzu ikule lava chutungi tingi ting lava nyamne ya re je kewe kewe mipa kewa kante chili ne chambale kumne inta nyinji kumne inta ti tsina sim tsichi pake yunga zi ne tuni ya tingi ting lava chi le yunga ya re
For the training in morality, mainly we have the morality of abandoning the 10 non-virtues. And so, for example, when you wake up in the morning, so first thing you go for refuge, and then if you were to think to yourself, now for the next 10 days I'm going to abandon the 10 non-virtues, then you would have that morality, training in morality. And or for example, like when if we take the Mahayana, if we practice the Mahayana Poshada, what we often call the Mahayana precepts, where we're thinking, for the sake of all sentient beings, in order to prevent illness and so forth, I'm going to take this vow until sunrise tomorrow. When you do that ceremony or that ritual, then you receive the vow or ordination, the dhamma, the ethical restraint of the Mahayana Poshada or the Mahayana precepts. So then you would get that particular kind of morality of abandoning the 10 non-virtues. So this, the practice of abandoning, the practice of the morality of abandoning the 10 non-virtues is the main way to achieve a birth of high status, in other words, birth as a human being or as a god. So just like it says in the explanation of the causes for achieving the leisures and endowments, in other words, the precious human rebirth, keeping the one of the three causes that are mentioned, main three causes that are mentioned, is the the keeping pure morality as a foundation or as a basis. So the main way in which you achieve birth of high status as a human being or as a god. And so then what this means, you see, is that even if you don't have one of the ordinations, the Pratimoksha ordination, in other words, the ordination or vows, ethical restraint of individual liberation, if you don't have the Bodhisattva vows, even if you don't have the Vajrayana vows, you can still practice the morality of abandoning the 10 non-virtues, and in this way you are said to close the door to being born in the unfortunate realms. So it's just like it said in the Lamrim teachings, the practice of refuge and the observance of karma and its results is the way to avoid being born in the lower realms. And so the kind of possibility that is there for us, if we want to, is we can think to ourselves, I'm not going to engage in killing for the rest of this life until I die. For the rest of my life, I won't kill. I won't engage in that particular non-virtue. So then you would have that one type of morality. And you could, you could likewise make the decision not to to steal for the rest of your life, not to engage, not to commit that non-virtue, the non-virtue of stealing, taking what is not given. So there would then you would have again there you'd have one morality, one type of morality. And so then you what you can do is you can make the decision that for the rest of your life, you it's a decision you would make in front of some holy object. Imagine at least some holy object in front of you in whose presence you're going to make this promise to abandon all the 10 non-virtues for the rest of this life. You can do that. That's something that you can do. So as I mentioned again, the morality of abandoning the 10 non-virtues is the principal method for avoiding being born in the unfortunate realms after this life. Because the 10 non-virtues are mainly what cause us to be born in those unfortunate realms. So abandoning them is the way to avoid them, avoid that kind of birth. Then in the as far as the training and concentration is concerned, mainly that refers to shamatha or calm abiding. And the how long you keep your mind one-pointedly on an object is not the point. You could keep your mind one-pointedly on some a virtuous object for 1 hour, and in that case you would have been practicing the training of concentration for 1 hour. Likewise, you could keep your mind one-pointedly on an object, virtuous object, for 5 minutes, and that would be the training in concentration. So however long the time is that you remain on the object, it would be the training in concentration. So you could keep your mind for 5 minutes one-pointedly in the practice of refuge, 5 or 6 minutes, then it would be the training in concentration. During that time, the destructive thoughts and emotions wouldn't be able to become manifest in your mind. Like, for example, if you keep your mind one-pointedly focused on the practice of love, loving kindness, then during that time, anger won't be able to manifest. So you can put your mind on any virtuous referent or any virtuous object, like loving kindness, like compassion, and whatever the duration of that one-pointed meditation is, it would be the training in training in concentration.
That is lava syrup, lava sedate, so the donito vela dondere, and the lava syrup, lava latene, and the Nyoma Bazawa de Chiba Pansi, I did donito vela dondere, and the Nyoma Sabin Pangu Yerva, Tatsu de donito vela dondere, tene, Chitan lava syrup, lava mambuyare. Ani kansagitami rabatobe ani shirab kilaba seyatete medabatobe shirab kilaba yari medabatobe shirab yarba otis chabina ngaranju jule tat rashimeba sosum konsum shirab yarba rashimeba tobe shi tujung samjungus tobashi jabala tene ta chedam jara shime ba kwa cha suna ne ran shime ba to be tujung shirep gi ge yare po are cha suna odi yesa ne ta di ngara ju chedam jara shime ba yin ju kwa rep cha suna ne shirab gilaba gi gi yarwa shirab gilaba nyam ne le gi yare ran ji kil shirab gilaba nyam ne yarwa ta meta chudan me meta ba yin bar ba ta ya du je tam je meta ba yin bar ba so ba tin de to bi nyam ne ta tin ne ya Sherif Gulabala, Tenshi Medalas, Tobi Sherif. Tenshi Medalas, Judo Tobi Sherif, Seat in the Yari. Oh, the Yusanta Karasuri. Oh, the Yusanganju Kule, Sherif Labe, Yamne Yari. Dengan tinggi lebih nyamne cung sunga, waktu isa cita hana tu nyamne yari, tombani tele pub, tombani tele pub ne, tombani kuat, ranjule kuat capa yari ba, tu je, ni tu ni tu bisiru nyamne le yung yari, waktu isa, ane ngaradu kule lebih sungi nyamne dapat yari. Yuva in Sanita, Ninjuga Sambe Gunelanti, Taba Dunyuga Sambe Gunelanti, Lam Lava Sum Lovati Chunsunatin, Jibu Dingi Yamleti Leungari, Jibu Ding Siati, Anitiri. Kibu jingi nyamne le yungwere. Tati kibu jingi nyamne ti tsuti tiri. Kibu jingi kapsu labja ti lama laba sumla zi labya ti che. Ti kulung ti ane tanduk lo tiri. Tanduk lo ti. Tanduk lo ti la teni ane lama laba sumla lo basi tu kulung ti tabatungi lo ti che. Ani te labja ti lam laba sumla lobya ti che. Ta tandu gulo ti kende sikyo gure se ne, ani dunghe gine ju ma yana ya yandu sambala tene, ani kua di le targu tu sambala lo ti gigi yareba. Ani chue chendu gulo gigi yare. Ta yodi yinsa ne ta dunghe gine ju mambu sam. Tene dunghe le tandu gulo ti gigi yare. Tungeg neju masam na tungel tandugula kigi marba. Tungeg naju ti sangut. Ti insa ta onju ti labasum ki nyamne esya ti che.
Then with the training in wisdom, this mainly refers to the special inside realizing emptiness. What I mean is that when we say that it's this it's the training in wisdom which is able to abandon the seeds of the klesha or the destructive thoughts and emotions. It's the training in wisdom which is the special insight realizing emptiness that's able to do that. Otherwise, in general, there are many different types of special insight because there are many different types of wisdom. So you have the wisdom realizing the gross selflessness of the person, for example. You have the wisdom realizing emptiness. So correspondingly, you have the special insight realizing the gross selflessness of the person and the special insight realizing impermanence. You have the special insight realizing the emptiness of the nature or natural existence of the three spheres and so forth. And we can have that at the level of the wisdom arising from listening or study, then the wisdom understanding that which arises through contemplation and so forth. So when having reflected on the meaning of selflessness or emptiness of natural existence, and you have some understanding of that, when you understood it, then that would be the wisdom arising from listening, or the more generally the wisdom arising from studying. So then again, there are many different types of wisdom. You have the wisdom which understands that all compounded phenomena are impermanent. So when that wisdom would be included within the training in wisdom, and you also have the wisdom realizing the 16 aspects of the four noble truths, such as impermanence and so forth. So it's said that we do have the training in wisdom. That's something that we do have. Like when you're trying to settle the meaning of or determine the meaning of emptiness, and through that you come to understand it, then you have the training in wisdom. So actually we have all three trainings. And when the motivation for practicing those three trainings is the mind of renunciation, then the practice, your practice of the three trainings would be a middle scope practice. And that is in fact the main practice of the person of middle scope or middling capacity. So what this means is that when the motivation, the kunlong, is the mind wishing to achieve liberation, then it would be that practice of the three higher trainings would be a middle scope practice. So that's the motivation, and what you actually would train in what you need to train in when you're trying to achieve that goal, when you want to achieve liberation, would be the three trainings, and how that motivation which is the mind wanting to achieve liberation arises is by reflecting again and again, reflecting repeatedly on the suffering nature of cyclic existence. When you do that, then what will happen is the mind wanting to be free from that will arise. If you don't reflect on the suffering nature of psychic existence, then there's no way that the mind wishing to achieve liberation from it will arise.
Lam laba sumla, suishin to lom never jingle up to suitatil, rangitula, sanget, toantoji chanjukum. Catucum nendiere, cum, anitilia, soataviati, caress de Britain, matada massimje tamje, taba tungi, lojene. Lam laba sumla tuition to lum never jingle up to suatab. This suatabal at any, Niji lamal he quit chali duty. Visita, duty nango visit the chevy gum, but. Only that she seemed yet time jig lose him the shoe, Luita sem nigal the shoe. Tominess a bit did tamjeta, keva to your taba to you, Lo kevala, taba to you, any. And the Lord Jane Lam Lava Sum La Tuition to Loba La Kiji, Yarba Kiji, any Kiji to Spachang Lu Dance Viger and Shijin to Guru Cheta Sunum no Dogi in the Tamje Pishi Keba Jess Keba to your Taba to Nigu Lord Jane Lava Sum Tuition to Lobe Toba Keba Jingula. Rashi Simje Tamji Gule Keva Sam Stati Suatavia di Tirita Suatavia di Vatice Tati Tusima.
And then it says, therefore, Guru Deity, please bless all Mother Sentient Beings and myself now to be able to learn properly, trained properly in the path of the three higher trainings after developing, or on the basis of having developed a desire for liberation, that mind wishing to achieve in liberation. So what this means is that you you're meditating on the the Guru Shakyamuni Vajradhara on the crown of your head, and you make a request. The request you make is for yourself and all the sentient beings to be able to generate the mind wanting to achieve liberation, and to be able, based on that, to practice the three trainings. And then, because of your request, the light and nectar of the five colors comes from the body of the guru on the crown of your head, and enters into the body and mind of oneself and all the mother sentient beings. And you imagine that light and nectar purifies all of the negativities, so the negativities and obscurations which have been accumulating since beginningless time. So all of that is completely purified, and then especially, so that's general, especially you think that all the hindrances for oneself and all sentient beings to be able to generate the mind wishing to achieve liberation, and all of the hindrances to practicing the three trainings based on that. So all of the hindrances to oneself and all sentient beings completely eliminated, and you oneself and all sentient beings generate the mind wishing to achieve liberation and the practice of the three trainings.
Tati, jujusi nangasitu, usi nangasitu ga ti ishi ngan tsungi yari. Jujusi, jujugi gyuri tsungi yari, usi gi, usi, gyuri da usi singi yari ba. Jujusi nangatigi, kato namba ngabu tiki ishi nga tsunsi. Ishi nga siya chi menu tabi ishi, nyamni ishi, chetu ishi. Ani sordo ishi. Ani gaji chunsu.
Chuyin.
Ah.
Chuyin ishi.
Ah.
Chuyin. Chuyin
ishi. Chuyin ishi. Oti ishi nga ti tsungere. Ishi nga ti Gyawari nga dhubshi dhiri, gyawari nga siya dhi. O di ji jya di chun, dine digi dhiji yuese si dhi, dhiji ki gyuli chun sige. Yuese li digi, ani yuese chun. Yuese chagji chambu siya dhi chun. Jasan di nga gulu, jasan di dhiji yuese di ji dhi, aranzi gyuli dhubji ki nubha shaya. Vese dhubji ki nubha shaya, odi chiche, ishi nga dhubya ki nubha shaya, chigiyarabha. Odi insa ta dhuji vese, dhuji vese, dhuji vese, dhuji vese da chepe gyunba, rashi samja tamji ki lu simla shu, Tome ne sabi diri tamje dang. So da dije, da dije su, da dije usi di usi na nga siya di. Da di nga di dewa yinsan o di dije usi. Dile dije di usi niga bebjang tiyari. Dulu li ina da usi bebjang siya. Dije bebjang di, dije bebjang siya chiyari. Vese di mebe yinpare, vese bebe jansi gare, vese chuse shige yare. Dulu li na zu, duji vese se se, niga ma chebe che, vese gule vese chu, ane chichi chi, titip taan se shige duga dulu la. Tiki taat vese di dulu ne shige yare ba, karasane chaja chambu di. Dulu ki chayi chambu yari, ngalu ki chayi chambu yari ba. Ta vese tiki gyulu, duji tiki gyulu chumba yansani, ta dulu la gyulu siya chi, sungi ya marwa.
No.
Che sa tele tuje si tiche.
No. And it mentions maybe in the commentary. In fact, in the commentary, yeah, bottom of page 105. With this application streams of, I can't say in the root text. But anyway, it's okay. When you're doing this visualization, then you're imagining that lights and nectars with five colors, five different colors of lights and nectars descend from the body of the guru on the crown of your head to oneself and all sentient beings entering the body and mind of oneself and all sentient beings. So the fact that there are five different colors, this represents or symbolizes the five exalted wisdoms. So the five exalted wisdoms are the exalted the mirror-like exalted wisdom, the exalted wisdom of equality, of accomplishing activities, then the exalted wisdom of individual analysis, and then the exalted wisdom of Dhammadhatu, Chuying. So these five wisdoms are the basis through which you eventually achieve the five types of Tathagata, you know, the five, what we usually call the five Dhyani Buddhas. And so that's why there are five. And then the symbolism of the nectar and light. So the nectar symbolizes the illusory body, and the light symbolizes the clear light. In other words, the clear light of the Mahamudra, the great seal. And so when you do this meditation in this way with purification, with the lights and nectars, then you create, literally, you know, you deposit the ability to achieve the illusory body, and also you create the potential, the ability to achieve the clear light. And so, you would think that you imagine that the lights and nectars descend into the body and mind of oneself and all sentient beings, purifying all of the obscurations and negativities and so forth, as I explained. So having both the nectar and light is something that we have in the visualization when it's in connection with the Vajrayana. Otherwise, in the sutra practice, if it's just a sutra practice, then you wouldn't have the nectar, you would only have the light rays. And the reason for this is that in the sutra system, we do have the Mahamudra, the great seal Mahamudra. So you have the Mahamudra in both sutra and tantra. So that's why we have the purification with light in the sutra practice. But in the sutra practice, there's no explanation of the illusory body. And for that reason, when we're doing the purification, you only have purification with light, not with nectar.
So in the Tamji Pesci gave a jet daddy. Did you Tamji Tam and Mabatiche? We are a jet. That Louis Tanse wicked. Only Louis de Sheru de Jig Louis Sierva did be Tanse wicked and Sheriff Jurusum, some chiggy, chiggier, teacher sooner. Any Julu to Chita, we say to Chicken Nube Shagari, Lu Tang say Viger and Shinchin to Kuru, Shada to Chig Luti, Mabaje, Wegen Schizen zu gehen. Eine Zeta, so einem, so in der Tamje, Gone Gondopin, Cessity, Cessity, so sehr. Cessity, Lung, Sunding Lung, sehr jerry, Daddy. Cessinander, Lung, Senator. Cessity, Lung. Lung chashe chimbari lung songji lung singe jare aranjula cheda dileya chileya so sigi bari dipa jene lung de chimbari de de da namshi de jibe de da namshi de jibe de da namshi de dikare da lung di jigi bari da de Chetty chet to do the numshig dangibes lung di mad weir, but in it, dread the numshi dress at the mad river, and it the numshi kagache dress at the touch it to lewd of chill tengurva. Then a lewd tea surge, dread the numshig dangibes. So till Chessier, so sinna Chessierti, and it's a ring to pay, said she. So num said it, so num said it, and a chimbatons, chudim suata, and that the Jamini Jacumbala sobatus, Jesuna, so num sassir, so num said it. So good to jiggy give it our dealer. Sunum sweet, sunum so so sweet. That's it done. Sunum so in the time jet daddy said the sunum tada. Not longer in the air to be in the mambo yerba to see a cabbage. Narantucular longer in the yuna, longer in the tea cabbage. Tobar of the jam ninjilla so that in the tobe yunia to see ya. Jamiji Tobatus Yakone Combe to Jason Sambachi, duty, Bebalatini, a long dog in the Tamje, Peshi Gaber Jess.
Nimshi Chisanta Sedan Sok Chipper to Horbe.
Really?
And it's so down Sosingilung, Sosena Sosingilung.
Oh, to Sunday,
Jerdan, Namshiki Denshi.
Das zum Ding lang die Töte nahm sich Dänzig.
No. And then it mentions, I know where is this, I can't find it. But anyway, it mentions in the text that you should think that through this meditation, through the lights and nectars entering into your body and mind, the body, our usual body, which is made of flesh and blood and so forth, becomes clear and pure. It becomes light in nature. So the body in your meditation, you think that your body of flesh and blood ceases, and instead you have a body which is very clear and pure and light in nature. And it also mentions that due to this light and nectar entering your body and mind, the body, mind of oneself and all the mother sentient beings, then your lifespan increases. Your lifespan and your merit. So your lifespan increases. So the lifespan, the lifespan is the same as one's life, and life in this context refers to the wind, which is the life-bearing wind. So when we say life, it means a life-bearing wind, and this is the same as one's lifespan when we're talking about having a long life, having a long lifespan. So tse and sok. So so we whether we say lifespan or the wind energy, that this is increased, it's the same thing. So when we talk about this, the life, or the in other words, the life supporting or the life holding wind energy, we're talking about the wind energy which acts as the basis for warmth and for the consciousness. So we can see the connection when we consider that when our lifespan is severed, when our life in the sense of lifespan is severed, then the in other words, when it ceases, then the air, or the wind energy, which is the basis for the warmth and for the consciousness, that also ceases. So that's the that's the life in the sense of lifespan that increases. You think that increases. Also, your merit increases. So the merit from practicing morality, the merit from meditating on loving kindness and compassion, think that these all increase. So by the merit that you any kind of merit that you create, whether it's from the morality, loving, meditating on loving kindness, compassion, and so forth, that merit is the main cause for achieving the rupakaya, the form body of an enlightened being. So you think that the lifespan increases, also your merit increases, and then it also mentions your qualities also increase. So when we talk about qualities, we're talking about such qualities as the scriptural qualities, the qualities of realization, such as your experience of loving kindness and compassion. So you think that these are also vastly increased within you. So I'll stop my explanation there, and if there are any questions, then please ask. There's one back there. I can see an arm, but I can't see who the arm is connected to. Okay, it's Doug.
Thank you, Rinpoche. Rinpoche mentioned the five exalted wisdoms, mm-hmm. and one of those was individual analysis. Mm. Could Rinpoche explain what individual means in this context? Like, what qualifies that as individual analysis versus just analysis?
That image that yishi ngagi kabla the kasa soto yishi de chigra the sort kandan de sozo toba dang toba nila keba kariores sortok ste di karikogitos
da sozo toba sina chida yule Tianda Bardi, Mari, Susur Jenny Surgil, Yula, Jeba Jenny Surgil Sigiri, sort of Susur Tobi, she said, Chetam de Temba to Matu, Susur Jeva. Yan Tiba Tiba Maimba, Susur Jeva. Any Langja, the Langja Maimba, Susur Jeva, said she touched. Yarba, Tindichila, Susur Jeba, Soto, Susur Topas.
Tienata, Susur Topa, Tan Topanilla.
Cheva Yare,
Cheva Yare,
Yare. Tobaina, Susur Tobain Guiamare, Topa Dile, Tingi Chayare, Topa Dilla, Tingi Chati, Yula Susur Jubimarva, Nature Yare, Nature. Tobatile yule tichi tu nebe necha yaritis yule susur chug marwa. Nandu jata sheta sa tusu tobarwa. Ya tobatin mambu yari susur machubatin de yari.
Chitan chena da susur tobe toba toba seti penangansu
da toba seti namdo seti re.
Namdo?
Toba. Namdo siri. Toba siri.
Namdo.
Oh.
Okay, so so we've got this word sozo topa. The topa usually we would in this case we would just translate as like analysis or examination, investigation, analysis. Dojunyi, investigation and analysis, so like investigation. But actually, it's the very same word that we would very often translate as conceptual mind. So it's a conceptual mind. But when it comes together with this sozotopa, so then the individual investigation or individual analysis, then it has the connotation of checking whether, for example, such and such an object is perfect or not, whether it's good or not, whether all phenomena are truly existent or not. So it's analyzing, checking that, right? Whether such and such an action would be sinful or virtuous, whether this is something that I should practice or reject, and so on. That's what individual analysis does. Whereas when you take away the individual from it, then you're just left with this word analysis, which is actually the same word as, you know, just simply conceptual mind, a mind which conflates the mental image with the object, with the actual object. Like, for example, when we have the conceptual mind thinking of a vase, then what's you have the appearance of the to that mind of a mental image of the vase, and that conceptual mind confuses or conflates that mental image with the actual object. So there is a difference then between, my mistaken way of translating it, but generally speaking, when we say when we talk about that wisdom, it's usually called the wisdom of individual analysis. And when it comes up in the context of analysis and investigation, you don't just say conceptual mind, but actually it means this word alone does simply it's taken alone, then it has that connotation of being simply a conceptual mind, a mind which conflates the what's appearing, which is the mental image, with the actual object, which is a mental image of. So they are different. Okay.
So one is more discernment. One is more discerning, and one is more the topa.
Chesan the sozotopa se adi the jeba checking gilo na sigres. Ane the topa chipu yena ani injimiji the jeba checko maro. Yeah, because actually one thing that I've just remembered I left out. There is, when we just talk about the topa, the conceptual mind, that can actually be a mind which is focused one-pointedly on the object. It can actually be a mind of concentration. So in that case, it's not analyzing the object. No.
Sherep di Jevachi to Tenga di Jeva Jevesurichi co. Tenga di Dantsun did Sherep Yinea round up get Jenny di Sherep Tree. Could round up get Jeva Maritan the tea Tenga di round up Jeva Marie Sherep Jeva top di cola. Tina Shinchumarava. Ready round up to Jebamari. Bennett Ya shirab da chungde tu kibbe tingin zi yirba. Tingin zi di yula zizi tu nebarba. Di shirab di yula zizi tu nebari di nebati. Tingin zi topki nebarba. Kuran randopki nebamari. Kuran randop jina ku yula jebe namba jinrib shiba surjiriba. Yula ya tati yula zizi tu nege yari ne tu karasini. Dengen di da chungde du sunwe topki randupki neba mare di dengen di di topki neba re di nashin mambujaya re.
Nevertheless, actually there is a concentration. So concentration is a mental factor, right? When we talk about main minds and mental factors, so there's the mental factor concentration, which has the similarities, the five similarities with wisdom. In other words, you know, one main mind can have these two mental factors in its, as you know, the phrase we usually use, in its entourage, you know, so it's kind of like a cohort of mental factors associated with it by way of these five similarities. So that that concentration is it's because it's in the same entourage as the wisdom, which analyzes, it's also analyzing. That concentration is also analyzing, but it's not analyzing through its own strength or through its own force, rather through the force of being associated with the wisdom. So it's actually analyzing through the force of the wisdom. It's whereas the wisdom is analyzing through its own force, because the mental factor of wisdom is the mental factor that has the function of analyzing. The concentration has the function of staying one-pointedly on the object. So when these two occur in the same group of mental factors with one primary mind, one main mind, then the concentration is also going to be analyzing, but not through its own force, rather through the force of the wisdom. The wisdom is analyzing through its own force, and then because there is that wisdom is occurring together with the wisdom is also one-pointed, but not through its own force, rather through the force of the concentration. Yes.
Yeah.
Liken that to like doing the bodhicitta motivation before you do anything, like being held by bodhicitta.
Ah, le nida kahare. Da de benda chasha nanganso de janju ki sem ki kunlong chene ani de gewa chi. Tupso na ani gewa di janju ki sem ki simbares sungiroa. Didn't chik barbes.
Tita jiwa mani, tene ku tandeti ku nyimbo yarwa.
Nyamro, no.
Nyimbo yarwa. Janjuku semgi kulung siyati, kulung chani kiawa chitub shabatili janjuku semgi siin siyari, janjuku sem nyimbo yoku kukumari. Pena tunyi tosu na, Janju Semba di Tungi To Suna, Tungi To Be Shira di Janju Gusim Gi Sim Sigurji. Riti di Negasu ku Janju Gusim di Ngunju Di Yamarwa. Inaya ku Janju Gusim Gi Sim Sigurji. Tata Tande di Tsungden Siya di Kuni Nyumbo Yari. Sheba Kandaji ni Tsungden Namba Nga Tsung Siya, Semda Simju Siya Jirwa. Sem dang simju ni tsungde namba nga tsungin seji. Sem diga kodu simju kundru nga yoyubre. Sem gandhi jine dunba meba dunba dingin di shirab seji kundru nga sikere. Karasa tsua semba riba dushi yila jiba se kundru nga sikere. Ta dili jugu dili yungi nga sikere. Di kesem ganglo kodu yu sikere. Kesim kangalu kutu dhumba meba dhumba dhingi di shirab si ngas yuyo sikere. Di yuwa yinsa kesim jiga kutu
Alle Nyamson eine der Tondro gedor.
Ah, Nyamson der Tangur.
This is a bit different actually, because in the case of these two mental factors being in the same retinue of the one main mind, they would be occurring together. They would be simultaneous. Whereas in the case of the having bodhicitta as your motivation for whatever, you know, meditation or action it might be, then it doesn't have to be together with it. When we talk about being held by bodhicitta because bodhicitta was your motivation, for example, for meditating on emptiness, when a bodhisattva meditates on emptiness, then it has to be held by the bodhicitta, but the bodhicitta doesn't have to be present with it. It doesn't have to be, you know, it doesn't have to be manifest. It's jeba, so like its function. Ko jeba manyapa said ko jele manyapa raba chibrebe no. Yeah, so its function should remain undegenerated or undeteriorating, but it doesn't actually have to be manifest. If it be in the case of the, you know, the action held by bodhicitta, if its activity were to deteriorate, then that would mean you would have lost the bodhicitta. So in this case, the two mental factors of concentration and wisdom would occur together. They would have to occur together. So with, you know, mental factors, which, you know, so we talk about main mind or primary mind and mental factors, each primary mind has five omnipresent mental factors, which are the mental factors of feeling, discernment, attention, contact, and intention, those five. So, you know, each mind would have all five of those, and they would all happen at the same time. Then you also have the five object ascertaining mental factors, which would occur with every virtuous mind. So you have those five would be the recollection, appreciation, then aspiration, concentration, and wisdom, I guess. Yeah, wisdom. So there are those five that all virtuous minds would have to have. And so there is a connection between the main mind and the mental factors, and between the mental factors, in terms of the five, which are called the five similarities. So you have the five similarities: similarity of the referent, or in other words, the object, the time, aspect, and so forth. So, for example, with the object, if we're talking about a main mind which is perceiving a pillar, then so then the main mind and all of the mental factors would be referring to, in other words, the object of each of them, of every one of them, would be that that pillar. So whether you think I'm saying pillar or pillow, it's the same thing anyway. So the aspect, so in this case, you know, it's quite simple. It would be they would each be seeing that in the aspect of a pillar. And so then also, you know, the duration would be the same, and so forth. The time would be the same. So you know, those are the, when we talk about two mental factors, concentration and wisdom, having the similarities, it means having those five similarities, which of which I've mentioned a few.
Yeah, yeah.
So we'll stop there. Sajje bhagye jojje me do chan jirali jini digim bade sangye jindu me devai dogyo namda jingla chepa sho etam guru rana mendala kamye daya me rimboje magye panangi guji kyaba nyamba me vayi Kone kondu pevara shu Kore shingandi pendan dewa malu junwen Jenre ziwan den zingya zo ye Shabe zite bad tengjuru ji Kalden duje kamsu tinle cho Toju tabu lundo gizich Lose namra rilandumi din landungi vishela sewa din.